Thank you, Jim Morhard, and thank you, Bob Cabana, for always doing a great job here at the Kennedy Space Center. Welcome to our astronauts. Before we start talking about and talking to our astronauts, I want to recognize what's happened here at the Kennedy Space Center. Transformational activities that have resulted in this being a multi-user spaceport, and Colonel Bob Cabana has been leading this effort for over a decade now, and it's been amazing. And the partners that we have with SpaceX and Boeing as it relates to our commercial launches, Bob, we're so grateful for all of your service. And of course, Jim Morhard, thank you for the introduction. I will tell you, right now NASA has the highest budget it's ever had in nominal dollars. It doesn't hurt to have a deputy administrator who comes from the legislative arena, who has worked in the Senate, and who can help us accomplish these big things. So thank you to Jim Morhard as well. So today we are taking another big leap in this transformation in how we do human spaceflight. And what we're talking about here is the commercialization of space, where NASA is one customer of many customers in a very robust commercial marketplace in low Earth orbit. What we're doing is we're transitioning from a test flight to operational flights. Make no mistake, every flight is a test flight when it comes to space travel. But it's also true that we need to routinely be able to go to the International Space Station. And so we're grateful once again to our partners from SpaceX for the Falcon 9 rocket and the Crew Dragon. We're also grateful to the NASA team that has worked so hard to get our astronauts ready. And of course, we're exceptionally grateful to our astronauts themselves. It's important to note that back in 2012, when you think about the commercial launch industry, the United States of America had 0% of the global market share in commercial space launch because of the investments of NASA for the last 10 years. Because of these investments, commercial resupply and now commercial crew, over 70% of the commercial launch market is American. This is really about launching America and doing it in a way that is competitive, where we can get the absolute best value for every dollar that the American taxpayer gives us. So this is the transformation that's happening, and we are extremely excited about it. I will say we're here today to recognize the astronauts who are, of course, in quarantine and getting ready for what will be another historic flight. I'm going to introduce the mission commander, Mike Hopkins, who is an Air Force test flight engineer by trade. He's also an aerospace engineer from the University of Illinois. In fact, he played football at the University of Illinois and, of course, got a master's degree in aerospace engineering at Stanford as well. So please welcome Mike Hopkins.
Thank you, sir. And good afternoon. Good afternoon, Florida. Good afternoon, America. It feels really good to be here. I'd like to start off by just saying thank you on behalf of the crew of Resilience. On behalf of our families, we want to say a big thank you to all of the people at SpaceX, at NASA, and in the DoD that have been working tirelessly to get us to this point. It's really been an incredible effort by an incredible group of people. For the crew, we're ready. We've spent the last couple of weeks kind of fine-tuning our training, and we've also had an opportunity to spend a little bit of time at home with our families. And we're truly honored to be a part of this transition. As the administrator said, we're starting this new era where we're going to rotate crews to the International Space Station from American soils with our commercial partners like SpaceX. And so we're very excited to be a part of that. Colonel Cabana, thank you in advance for the hospitality, and we look forward to the week ahead. Thank you. And I guess I'm supposed to introduce the next crew member. So it's my honor as well to introduce Commander Victor Glover. Victor and I have been working here together for the past couple of years now. Victor is from Cal Poly. Victor also may have happened to play football, but on the other side of the ball. But it's definitely my honor to introduce Victor. You won't find a better astronaut out there, a better father, a better husband, a better person. Victor.
Thank you for the introduction, Hopper, and thank you, gentlemen, for the kind words. And welcome to all of you. Welcome to this very special place, the Kennedy Space Center Shuttle Landing Facility. I've never had the opportunity to land a space shuttle here, but I've landed the training aircraft that we fly. And every single time, I know that a few days later, I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna fly that jet out of here. And it's really special today because we flew an airplane in here, but the plan is for us to leave on top of a rocket. So that's pretty neat. That's pretty awesome. I just wanted to say thank you to everyone. You know, we have this great team. We have this great mission ahead of us, and we all look forward to getting on orbit and doing our best to make you all proud of us. So thank you for your support, and thank you for being here today. Go Falcon, go Dragon, and go Resilience. I have the honor of introducing my crewmate, Dr. Shannon Walker, and I will say that she's a great crewmate. Mike and I were at this for 2.5 years, and Shannon and Soichi were added to the crew about 6-8 months ago, and it has really been an amazing opportunity to learn from Shannon and Soichi, and her experience at NASA and her experience in the astronaut office have been very valuable to me, the rookie on the crew. And so I am greatly in debt to both of them for their experience, and so I would like to bring up Shannon Walker.
All right, thank you so much. It is so exciting to be here. As Victor said, I've been in the astronaut office a long time. I've had one other flight. I did not launch out of Florida for that flight. And so I am just so happy to be here in Florida getting ready for this launch. The difficulty with going third in line here is everybody has already said thank you to everybody, but I'll just echo their thanks to the whole team that have gotten us here, our training team, the people building the hardware, the space station that's ready for us. It's just so exciting. So thank you everybody for coming out and seeing us off. And with that, I think I'll just hand it over to my crewmate Soichi. Soichi is somebody that I have known for a very long time. As luck would have it, on his last shuttle flight, he actually flew with my husband, and so I had all the stories about Soichi, and now I have the privilege of actually flying with Soichi this time. So I'm very grateful. Thank you, Soichi.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shannon. Yeah, I have to do the speech in Japanese and English, so start off with Japanese.
日本の皆さん、こんにちは。 15年ぶりにこのケネディ宇宙センターにプライムクルーとして来ること、とても嬉しく思っています。今大変な時期ですけれども、日本で応援してくださっている大切な皆さんのためにもこのミッションをお届けしたいと思います。このミッションが日本の皆様に夢と希望と感動を分かち合えるように全集中で頑張りたいと思います。行ってきます。
Now I'm going to switch to English. Boy, it's such a nice feeling to be here as a prime crew. Believe me, this is the best part of astronaut life, prime crew in KSC. I'd like to thank everybody to support our training the last 8 months. It's been a tough time. It's been a long wait. But the Crew-1 is in town, and we are the only game in town this week. And we go to space with pride. Our name is Resilience. Resilience is power to recover, will to restore, and we strive to survive. Our patch has no name on it because our mission is for everyone. In fact, Crew-1 is U-1. All for one, one for all. Now, let's go fly.